Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to easily merge multiple photos of an individual scene into one seamless image using Photoshop's Photomerge command. And then, if you watch my tutorial on the black and white and the photographic toning adjustment layers, I'll show you how to transform it into a stunning dramatic image. I provided the link to that tutorial in the video description. To achieve the best results, make sure you follow a couple of guidelines when you snap your photos. First, be sure to remain standing in the same spot. Second, make sure you overlap each image by at least 25% so that Photoshop has enough detail to compare between images when trying to stitch them together. Lastly, maintain the same exposure in each photo and use one focal length. In other words, don't zoom in or out. I find that the simplest way to begin is to open the individual snapshots that will ultimately comprise your final stitched image. Once you have them opened, go to File, Automate, and Photo Merge. There are 6 layouts from which to choose. Depending on the type of lens you're using will determine which layout is best suited to give you the best results. I generally like to try all the layouts to see which one I like the best. Using Auto will analyze your source images and chooses what it thinks is the best layout to use. However, you may find you prefer a different layout. Perspective uses your middle image as the reference and skews or stretches the other images on either side of the middle image so that the overlapping content is matched to the middle image. Cylindrical is best suited for creating wide panoramas. It reduces the bow tie distortion by displaying individual images as on an unfolded cylinder. Spherical is best suited for 360-degree panoramas. It aligns and transforms the images as if they were mapping the inside of a sphere. Collage will rotate or scale any of the source layers to match overlapping content. I generally prefer the reposition layout because it aligns and matches the source images and doesn't stretch or skew them. For this example, I'll take the reposition layout. Make sure blend images together is checked. Unless you intend to retouch the layer masks by hand, make sure this is checked. The vignette removal corrects darkened edges that may happen when using wide-angle lenses. Geometric distortion correction is best suited for fisheye lenses. It compensates for barrel, pincushion, or fisheye distortion. Click Add Open Files. This places all of your open files into this window. If you don't have your individual files opened, click Browse and choose your files. When they appear in this window, click OK and Photomerge will automatically do the rest. Basically, it's creating one multi-layer image from the source images, adding layer masks as needed to create the best blending where the images overlap. Merge all your layers by pressing Ctrl-E on Windows or Command-E on a Mac. When you use Photomerge, your image will always have empty areas along its perimeter. The fastest ways to remove them are either to crop your image, thereby cutting away the empty areas, or you can use Contentaware to fill them in. If you choose to crop it, open your Rectangular Marquee tool and drag a rectangular selection over your image, making sure the selection is cropping out the empty areas. Then go to Image and Crop. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. Notice the empty areas have been cropped away, leaving a tighter but clean image. If you don't want your image cropped, use Contentaware Fill. I'll revert the image back before I cropped it. First, I think I'd like to rotate this image so the Eiffel Tower is more vertical. I'll go to Edit, Transform, and Rotate. I'll rotate it, and then press Enter or Return to accept it. To fill in the empty areas with Contentaware, we first need to make selections around them. For this example, I'll open the Lasso tool and draw around the section of an empty area. Contentaware works best in small sections. Go to Edit, Fill, and Contentaware. Click OK, and Contentaware will fill it in. Then deselect it. draw around another section, and this time, to open Contentaware, we'll use a shortcut by pressing Shift plus the F5 key at the top of your keyboard. Press Enter or Return to fill it in, and then deselect it. Continue this process until all the empty areas are filled in. Once you've created your seamless image, you can transform it into a stunning, dramatic image using the techniques that I'll show you in my tutorial on the black and white and photographic toning adjustment layers. The link to that tutorial is located in the video description. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.